So very warm welcome to class 10. Now all are in. I expect the maximum more number of attendance to be there in my class. And now when we are going to start with the revision portion, that is going to be the most crucial time. If you all miss those revision part, that is going to be a big headache for you all. So I expect you all should remain along with me and move ahead for your betterment of your result. And today we are going, what we are going to do is, it's an interactive session of last chapter, that is Glimpses of India. We will be discussing it in detailed manner. And I expect the answers from those students, those who never open the mouth. And children, this is just a class where we, myself and you are here. No one else is here. At least you should open your mouth. It may be wrong, no issues. I will correct it, but speak up. That's the most important part. Just speak up, okay? So we have discussed about, this is the first part what we can see. Glimpses of India. I would like to listen this from Arihant Jain. Arihant Jain, are you there? Arihant Jain.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Good morning. I just want to know that you're not well. You're not well.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you not well?
Yes, ma'am. Wake up and cold.
Arihant, I just want to know that do you remember this part which I have already explained?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you just brief it?
No, ma'am.
Why, beta?
Ma'am, I'm not feeling well, ma'am. I'm not having the book right now.
Achha. Theek hai. Dekhte hain. Himanshu? Himanshu, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you just tell me brief this first part? Can you just brief me this first part, Himanshu? No. Akshat Kocher? No answer. Suvrat? And such a nice experience, na? Suvrat?
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Can you just brief it, beta?
Yes, ma'am. My voice is lagging.
Can you just brief this chapter? First part?
Ma'am, your voice is lagging.
Ma'am.
No. Good.
Ma'am. Ma'am, your voice is lagging.
I am in the Wi-Fi zone and sitting in school itself. So it's not my fault.
Oh, it's clear.
Bhavi? Bhavi? See the condition. Bhavi? Bhavi, talk.
Ma'am, now it's lagging.
Divyansh?
नो मैम, क्लियर है आपकी आवाज।
दिव्यांश कटरीना,
यस मैम।
बेटा कैन यू जस्ट डिस्क्राइब इट
मैम, इन माय एरिया डोंट नो योर मींस वॉइस इज कमिंग वेरी लो, लो साउंड।
बेटा योर वॉइस इज कमिंग लो मैम।
नो मैम, एवरीथिंग इज ओके।
सो दिव्यांश, दिव्यांश कैन यू लिसन टू मी?
Yes, ma'am. Now, the voice came, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, can you just brief this chapter, first part?
Ma'am, that means Kurg one.
No. A baker from Goa. In introduction. Can you see that in on the screen? The name is written.
No, ma'am. Only showing that download notes part 3.
What is showing?
Download notes part 3, that front page of that English class 10.
Okay, wait. Doing it once again. Can you see now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Now. Huh.
Okay. So, can you just brief it? Divyansh?
Do I have to read it?
No, you have to brief it. I have already explained. What I can understand is, after Diwali also you are not in the class. You just enter into for the attendance, that's all. Now come up by yourself. Who will explain me? I know Nandika will raise the hand. Except
ma'am, may I try?
Nandika and Viram. Wait, let me see other hands also. If anyone else is there. Akshat Jain. Yes, Akshat. Viram, I know, but wait. Akshat.
Ma'am, good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, may I try?
Yes, you are most welcome, beta. Please try. Yes, Akshat. Waiting for you.
This story is telling about the place that is Goa. The past time when Portuguese rule was there, that the writer used to tell us that the bakers of Goa were also known as poder, who baked the breads, and the meal of Goa was means staple meal of Goa was bread. The small children were also eating that and having fun to eat that, and they all enjoy that time. And the poet also missed those times. Ma'am, that's all.
At least I'm happy, beta, you have tried. Means that's really very good. But other students, even they have not opened the mouth also. Fine. Yes, Viram, you want to continue, please?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, this, ma'am, first part or second part?
First.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the first part of Glimpses of India is a baker from Goa. Goa is an Indian state which is located in southwestern part of country. This state is having its historical importance since beginning, as Portuguese were first to enter this state only. And this state is having great history in many means criteria. One which we have is about the widespread and most important profession in Goa. The bakers, the local bakers, used to visit villages every morning to sell their products. The big and largely known bakeries are yet also available in Goa, which are run by their generation, the next and next generation. Previously, they used to wear a single piece clothes and roam into the village for selling their product. By the evening, their product get fully sold. And they only left with some of the ring of bread that children used to take from them. And now they used to wear t-shirts and trousers and then sell it. Previously, they used to calculate the bill in wall by writing with pencils. But now it is been like they are calculating with means paper and pen. That is the development we can see in bakery profession. And ma'am, this part also means this part of chapter also tells that bakery has an historic importance in Goa. Previously bread were generally used in Europe, not in Indian countries. But when Portuguese came, they introduced that bread and all, and it became most important now. Everything we used to use now, generally it contain bread and that type of material. So this part is like that only.
You have forgotten few main important points, Viram. Portuguese were calling these bakers as kis naam se pukarte the?
Ma'am, actually I am not aware with that particular name.
Ma'am, Poder. Poder. Padder. Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Beta, you have to keep this thing in mind, okay? So these are the main
things
about the name of the dress. Many important lines are there. Okay?
Dress was known as kabai.
Yes.
Ma'am, and also when they went for selling their products, they produce jang jang sound.
With the help of?
Bamboo stick.
Bamboo stick.
Stick.
Yes, ma'am.
Bamboo stick. Bamboo.
So now, who will explain the second part? Nandika.
Ma'am, may I?
Is it Nandika or someone else?
Yes, ma'am, it's me.
Just hold on. Just hold on. Okay. Yes, Nandika, you can start.
Ma'am, from the second part.
Yes, you start first. Then I will ask you to you do it first.
Okay, ma'am. The second part of the chapter, Glimpses of India, is Coorg. Coorg is a coffee country. It's known as a coffee country. It's most famous for its rainforests, its scenic beauty, and its spices and coffee. So Coorg is a place in the southern state of Karnataka. It is the previous name of Coorg was Kodagu, and it is a very small place in Karnataka, and it is midway between Mysore and the coastal town of Mangalore. So it is very popular. Mostly it is known for its coffee. Most of the coffee production of the country is done there. And the people over there are said to be the descendants of Arabic, of Arabic people, or the Alexander's army was said to be, they were said to have descendants over there. So they are not completely of an Indian ethnicity, but, as told in the as written in the chapter, and they have a special type of attire known as kapia or kafia, or and it is very similar to the Arabic form of attire. So Kurgi people have the tradition of hospitality. They are very welcoming to people from other places, and the scenic beauty is quite pristine over there. It is they are describing about all the animals that are found there, and the largest Tibetan Buddhist monastery is also located in those valleys and those hills of Kurg.
Okay, so it was like literally a description about the Kurg place, right? Karnataka place, and they are being, yeah. The third one, I would like to listen it from Deshna Kakaria. Are you there? Deshna Kakaria, are you there?
Ma'am, your voice is lagging now.
No, ma'am, it's clear.
Very clear.
It's clear.
Okay, she is not connected to
network issue, might be.
Okay. Who will describe the third part?
Ma'am, may I?
Yes, sure.
Ma'am, the third part of the glimpses of India is the tea from Assam. Here, the narrator is telling about Assam, which has the largest concentration of tea, via a dialogue of two children. The students' names are Rajveer and Pranjal. Pranjal.
Bas.
Yes, ma'am.
I thought that you are going to describe it nicely. Fine, Khushi.
Yes, ma'am.
Please, you may continue. You want to describe?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the tree from Assam is an interesting, informative lesson about the tea plantation. And in this chapter, the writer was tried to make it is interesting. And two young boys, are Pranjal and Rajveer, are going to Assam. And the Rajveer is excited as he passes through tea gardens and wants to share his knowledge with Pranjal. They talk about various Indian and Chinese legends behind tea, and Rajveer tells Pranjal a very interesting story of a Chinese emperor who described tea for chances. He also tells Pranjal another story which is very strange and logical. And this story tells us about the growing up of tea leaves.
Continue. I am listening. I'm waiting.
Ma'am, this much.
Kushal?
Ma'am, may I continue?
Kushal? Kushal Khajanchi? Are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
बेटा इतना लंबा लंबा आंसर लिख रहे हो, यू आर राइटिंग सच ए बिग बिग आंसर्स, बेटर यू शुड स्पीक आउट. यस प्लीज डू स्टार्ट एक्सप्लेन द थर्ड लेसन, दैट पार्ट ऑफ द ग्लिम्सेस ऑफ इंडिया.
He from Assam is an informative story written by Dhruv Kumar Datta. Pranjal's father is the manager of a tea garden in Assam. Pranjal has invited Rajvi to visit his home during the summer vacation.
That's all. That's all.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, you would have worked a little bit hard. You can describe it so nicely. You are continuously typing. Krishi, your words are
right this much.
Achha, okay. At least you have read, now that is enough. Krishi, you need to work hard a little bit. You need to describe it in a beautiful manner. Okay, beta. Darshan. Birthday boy.
Yes, ma'am.
Happy birthday, first of all.
Thank you, ma'am.
God bless you. And you want to describe the third part of Glimpses of India?
Yes, ma'am.
Please go ahead.
Ma'am, here the narrator, Arup Kumar Datta, is telling about Assam, which is known for the tea. In the story, he is telling like dialogue between the two students. Their names are Rajveer and Pranjal. And Pranjal's father is the manager of the tea garden in Assam. And Pranjal has invited to Rajveer to come there and see the garden and that all. And so they had traveled in train to go to Assam. Pranjal was telling everything about the tea gardens, popularity of tea, everything, the requirements of the tea he was telling to him. And so Rajveer was also having some knowledge about tea, so he told that the tea was first drank in China in 2700 BC ago, and the word like tea, chai, chini are also Chinese words. And then when they after that long journey, they have all seen the tea gardens and that all stuff. Then they have reached to a station called Mariani Junction, where Pranjal's parents were there to receive them both. And then they have gone to Dekhabari tea plantation, and it was managed by Pranjal's brothers. And when they were traveling, they were just describing about the road, the side, the scenery of there. He was telling that on the sides of the road, there were tea bushes, full of tea bushes, and that much only.
No, nicely. At least you have elaborated it and described the scenery. So let me now conclude the particular whole lesson, and listen to me very carefully. A few important points I need to tell you all once again before I end up. That is, you all are going to have a very soon career counseling session conducted by CBSE heads of counseling section. We have a new ma'am along with us, our new principal director, ma'am Kalpana ma'am. She has decided to have PTM, and we are going to now have PTM one-to-one, and we are going to welcome you all one by one. We will be sending the invitation to meet you all with your parents and to know about your issues, whatever subject you are willing to move ahead, your career. And we are really concerned about your career, children. And we are going to give the utmost facilities what we can. Now there is going to be a change. Ma'am is going to soon conduct the meeting after the discussion, and you will be having a career counseling. Your main motive, your aim, we are going to mainly focus on. And if you're not confined to your decision, we are there to sort out. And soon a very positive decision is going to be taken ahead by our admin, head of the department, like principal ma'am and the principal director ma'am. Okay. So this was the first information to be given to you all. Very soon we are going to move into a beautiful, something very new and really effective and a positive aspect. So let's wait and let's cross our fingers that we all are going to be together, okay, ahead in our journey, so that I can make you all more and more focus on Amita, online. It may be one-to-one, in special invitations will be given, a few, one by one. It will be coming to you. Notice aayega, sab kuch aayega. Before that, I will be having one PTM.
Ma'am, Sunita ma'am was saying that we will be getting
today answers. Today we will got our PDF.
Ha, I think so.
Yes, ma'am, she was saying.
I have already uploaded.
Objects.
Fine. Please go through the mobile only. See it in mobile. Because many PDFs are like it is not opening in laptop. Someone will be saying that PC. There are many issues. Na? Someone is having Windows 10, Windows 7, both are the issues. Oh, see it in mobile. Okay. And I'm telling you regarding your this answer sheets, I am not so strict this time, but I'm telling you, children, in the upcoming examinations, I will be very, 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 very much strict, because it was an online checking, so it was not possible to do that type of corrections, but ifs and buts we will be discussing in the upcoming classes. One period I will be keeping you all for the result discussion, means answer sheet discussion, because it was really very much tough for all of us to check the papers online. It was really, really tough. So our next point was like, yeah, I'm going to conclude this chapter. This chapter, Glimpses of India, is a very short children. Why this chapter is there in your chapter? Again, internal meaning I have not discussed with you all. Beauty expresses everything. That's true that we have seen. But children, in these three parts, you have seen one thing, that color, caste, and creed doesn't matter on this earth to survive. First point. It tells you about how to become, have a good relationship as a good human being. Second point. Third point is that how to develop yourself to develop your own culture and things. So it has been described in that small, small places, how the other foreign people came and set their own culture, but still we are ready to accept it. So we can say na Atithi Devo Bhava. This is the statement of Indian people, and you have a good relationship. How to have a good relationship, good human relationship. Okay. So these are the small morals which the lesson wants to give it to us. The next part is that how beautifully we know our place. Hum apne place ko kis tarike se jante hain. How we can describe about it. So many small things are there, which is actually been focused on, right? Indian beauty itself. And India itself has got so much within itself that there is no end to it. India ke paas so aisa itna kuch hai. So many things are there. Now we can see how it can be described, how it has been shown, how the moral values are given, children. All the chapters has got its own importance. Now, when I will begin with the revision part, it is going to be the most important session for you all. So, your homework for that 1 week when I will be taking leave is that You have to solve those two question papers that will be floated on Thursday night. Okay. And solve it, prepare the PDF and send it to me in my official mail ID. I expect it tomorrow, day after tomorrow, in the upcoming 3 days, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday, I will be dealing with some grammar topics. Okay. And it may be only one topic because now, as because I'm going to start the revision from tomorrow itself. So tomorrow topic, whatever I'm going to teach you, tomorrow I will teach, the other tomorrow you have to work on it. Okay. So I hope the things are very clear to you. And thank you so much for being with us. Take care. Stay safe. Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Good day, ma'am.
Good day.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye, ma'am. Good day, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Bye.
Good day, ma'am.
Good day.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.